and this here may be tough to you. Snack cake to me, yeah, more hosts.
All hosts.
This been overdue forever. Asked me when it was dropping, said never.
Never.
Should've made you cut the feather, but I designed it Freemason Margiela.
What's goody, Shell Drawing, you're the most woke, no joking. I'm back yet again with a brand new video, and won't bluff. I don't know what this link is that someone just sent me. Someone in my last video showed me a list, asked me if I seen something, and I definitely hadn't. And when I use this word, I know I've used this word at least, there's gotta be a counter somewhere. But the word of the day, of the week, of the month, of the year is disrespectful. When I say this, bro, I mean it from the bottom of my heart. People with the biggest credentials, with the most, I guess, what's the word I want to use here? They have the cachet, and they have the resources, and they have the infrastructure to do actual research, and then they don't. Like, how do you, that's gotta be tough. I would love to have a high paying job security, like the greatest job security of all time, and never have to actually own up to anything I say. This is sharing an opinion about something that it's expected of you as an NFL media senior analyst. I won't get to that just yet. Let's go down to PIP right now, man. Gil Brandt's greatest defensive ends of all time. This man is an NFL media senior analyst for NFL.com. Let's just go down this list real quick, man. When I say disrespect, we can talk about disrespect. First of all, Michael Bennett is number 31 all time on his defensive ends list. That should tell you already. Jared Allen actually is really good. But I don't want to go through all 31 of these names. I don't know why there's only 31 on this list. What kind of random number is 31? I mean, 30, even 30 is a weird number. But if you want to do 31, why not just go top 32? So there's 32 teams in the league. But we don't want to get through all that. What I want to talk about here is two players. And this isn't even the biggest snubs. Look, at number 18, this man, Gil Brandt, has Julius Peppers. Let's look at his stats. So he's been in the league from 2002 to 2017, voted to 9 Pro Bowls, first team All-Pro 3 times, 2004 NFC Defensive Player of the Year, NFL 2000s All-Decade Team. You hear me? NFL 2000s All-Decade Team. Has 143.5 career sacks, number 5 all time, 73 pass deflections, 11 interceptions, and 47 forced fumbles. And we're going to skip down over here. We got Ed Too Tall Jones, who should be a lot lower scrolling-wise, but higher ranked than where he is. Howie Long, Jason Taylor should be a little bit higher up this list. But then we get to, number 7? J.J. Watt. J.J. Watt is number 7 on this man's all-time list. So when I saw this, this is the point we wanted to make to me. He said, why is Julius Peppers ranked so much lower than J.J. Watt? And he said, I don't know if you saw this, bro, but if you hadn't, then you need to discuss this. And before I get into just how wrong this man is, if you don't know who my man Gil Brandt is, here he is. This fake Bill Murray, Colin Mockery looking Voldemort. I don't even want to talk about this man much further. But I can't make it up. I am not gonna look. There's a lot we can learn as a younger generation from our elders. There's a lot of knowledge, wisdom, experience, and know-how that the older generation has to share with younger people. But I don't want to hear about J.J. Watt being better than Julius Peppers. That's not something I'm going to listen to. That's not something that's something that I got to tell you. You might need to retire. Now, he's side-eyeing. You notice he's not looking at the camera in this picture. This man is side-eyeing retirement, and I hope he finds it. If you're looking for retirement, I hope you find it. I want to get into a little bit more detail of who Gil Brandt is. Gil Brandt, born March 4th, 1933, full stop. We ain't even got past the two words outside of his parentheses. Born 1933. To put that in perspective for you, that was 6 years before World War II. This man isn't even a baby boomer. This man was born before baby boomers. He's been around the game for way too long. I don't know what it is, bro. Because you know when you have these old heads in the game, usually they like to be, I guess, swayed toward the older players and the older generation. You know, like in basketball, people are like, yo, man, LeBron ain't the GOAT, man. Maybe it's Jordan. Maybe it's Wilt. Maybe it's, you know, it could be someone else. Like, they're not so fond of how the game is played now, and they like, they're still really connected and biased toward their era. But for someone this old, he's doing the exact opposite. In what world is JJ Watt a better defensive end than Julius Peppers? This man got his start. First of all, he's like the godfather of scouting, of new age methods for determining skills, determining potential. He definitely has the background. He has the credentials. He has everything you want in a person to be an official on talking about player talent. But I don't know about this one. But I don't want to get on this man too hard. So let's go ahead and go back to JJ Watt and his stats on the page. Look, voted to 4 Pro Bowls, first team All Pro 4 times, 3-time NFL Defensive Player of the Year, 2-time NFL sacks leader, 76 sacks, 45 passes defended, 15 forced fumbles, and scored 5 touchdowns in 6, but really 7 seasons. Look, those sound really good, but compare those to Julius Peppers. You know what we're going to do? I could compare it to Julius Peppers' full season, his full career stats, but let's keep it to his first 7 years in the league. So JJ Watt, in his first 7 years in the league, and before we get into this, I want to just make sure that I cover this. I know you're gonna say, but wait a minute though, bro. In Julius Peppers' first 7 years, he didn't really get injured, bro. He was doing his thing. And you know, JJ Watt only played 8 games in the past 2 years. That's only 8 out of 32 games possible. That's only a quarter of the games, bro. Yeah, you're playing probably one of the most physically demanding sports in the world, at the most physically demanding position in that sport. And you can't stay on the field. That's part of the job. That's part of the job description is staying healthy. Y'all know the old saying, the best ability is availability. And I'm going to hold not staying on the field against JJ Watt. Against both of them. That's how you would have to, if you keep getting injured, if you have a history of injury, then, I mean, that counts against you. It's uncontrollable for the most part. But yeah, I can't hurt Julius Peppers' ratings because he stayed healthy and J.J. Watt didn't. So in his first 7 seasons, J.J. Watt had 76 sacks. In Julius Peppers' first 7 seasons, I'll do the math for you myself. He had 70.5 sacks, I believe it was. I think it was 70.5, and that was his 8th, that was in 08. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so he had 70.5. But in his 8th season, he had 10.5. So he would have had 81 sacks in his 8th. He had 81 sacks after his 8th season. Can we say that my man JJ Watt is going to have, that's only 5 sacks. He'd probably get 5 sacks next year. That's if he stays healthy. And look at this real quick. So JJ Watt had, what do you have? 15 forced fumbles in his first 7 years. Okay. In his first 7 years, Julius Peppers had 30. Oh, that's only 25. Okay. He had 30 in his 8th season. So, he had 25 forced fumbles in his first 7 years. That's plus 10. That's plus 10 on JJ Watt. I mean, we can go stat by stat really if we really really wanted to, but I mean, one interception for J.J. Watt, and we're looking at, what is this, 4 for Julius Peppers. I mean, this is just crazy to me. I don't understand what's the comparison here. And that's only Julius Peppers, that's only his first 7 years we're talking about. Let's talk about his full career. This man, look at this man's sack numbers. And tell me, who was putting up these kind of numbers? And they're, This dude's been in the league 15, 16 years now. And he's still putting up these kind of numbers. And has only really had, I mean, he's played 16 games basically his whole career. JJ Watt, we're not even sure if he can even, I don't even think Texans fans, the biggest diehards could say that with confidence that J.J. Watt will play 16 games in the next two seasons. Julius Peppers has probably the most consistent career out of anyone over 15, 16 years in the league, playing in an extremely high collision position where you always, literally every play, you make contact. I thought greatness was defined as high performance, high productivity over time, right? I thought it was over time. We're not even sure if J.J. Watt is even going to be healthy enough to play two more seasons. We're not even sure if he's going to be able to play the full next season. I'd be willing to bet money right now that J.J. Watt does not see the field 16 straight games next season. J.J. Watt got to season 5, played all those games. 6 and 7, he couldn't even play 9 games. And Julius Peppers, after his 7th season, played 10 straight seasons of 16 games. Man, I'm done with this, bro. I need your opinion, man. I really have to understand what this man's thoughts were. I know, before you're in the comments saying this, I know that J.J. Watt is great. He's a really great player. But does he deserve to be ranked above Julius Peppers?
Cheers to you, appreciate the chance. Being told y'all I've been the man. Being told y'all I had the gift. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Real ones gonna recommend. Count this as another win.